everyone, good evening. So today I'm going to talk about, you know, code waves in Gatsby block. So how many of you know what is code waves? Yeah. Okay, so the code waves is a simple plugin which was written by Rodrigo Pombo. So he had actually written a plugin called Code Surfer for the MDX deck, and he extended the same kind of technology for the Gatsby also. So with this plugin, we can actually make our blog very presentable, very pleasant to read, pretty. So that is what I'm going to show you today, especially for the tech blogs. And this inspiration actually came from Zain Fatoni, thank you. In his last talk, I met him in the last talk, so he built a deck using this technology. So from there I got an inspiration and then started researching about. So the good thing is Rodrigo actually built his entire website with this plugin, and very recently he published a post how to build a React from scratch. You should definitely go and watch his read his blog, definitely. Yeah, so myself Vimal Raj Selvam, and you can find me anywhere with this name, or otherwise my social account is email to Vimal Raj. So Twitter, GitHub, everywhere I'm email to Vimal Raj. Hi. So this particular deck is being developed using the Code Surfer plugin, which is again written by, as I mentioned, Pombo. So okay, so to get started, we are going to create a new Gatsby blog, and this is a simple, blog plugin. Like, so you just execute this command, say Gatsby new Gatsby site. So that means you will be having the small Gatsby starter site in your system. So I'm just going to do that, Gatsby dollar. So after that, we'll install the required plugins. So we need the MDX plugins because we are going to write our post in the Markdown with the JSX support as well. So the plugin that supports, it's called MDX. So we have to install a couple of dependencies for that. After that, we'll install the code-based Gatsby theme. So very recently, Gatsby actually came up with an approach called Gatsby themes, other than the Gatsby plugins. So Gatsby themes will help you to install. So any starter kits, like say for an example, to start a new Gatsby site, you have to run a starter kit. So like if you look at here, the Gatsby new uses the basic starter kit from the Gatsby's GitHub. But the only problem here is the next time someone's update that particular starter kit, you will not be able to, get those changes. You have to rewrite or you have to rebuild your entire web application. So Gatsby came up with a theme approach wherein the themes can be installed as an NPM packages. So that's what this, the code-based plugin is also going to do. It has been published as a theme. So that means you can install it, and whenever there is an update, you can easily update and get the changes. And for this theme, for this plugin, there are few additional dependencies we need. That's Emotion Core. That's as you are well aware about those. Those are CSS and JS plugins. And yeah, so this uses a theme UI that is again to basically style your site. It's pretty configurable. So after installing, so this is a Gatsby config, a small Gatsby config. So this is the one which is by default generated when you create a new site using the starter kit, basic starter kit. So these are the few basic information that is readily available. So what are we going to do is we are going to add the MDX plugin because we are going to build our blog with the MDX. So I'm going to add this as a plugin. And after that, we are going to add two more, plugins in it. So that's a Gatsby theme waves, which will help us to, add the Waves plugin, code Waves plugin. And obviously, yeah, we have to add a theme UI. The reason is theme Waves is dependent on theme UI. So that's it. So now we can actually create a MDX page. We can go and create a MDX page. So that's simple. Just import the CodeWave plugin and we'll start creating our MDX page. Okay. So let's see a demo quickly. Hi. So if you look at here, this is a small MDX page that has been created. So I import a code wave component from the Gatsby theme waves. And you can start writing your code wave here. So every code wave will be rendered in your application as a separate component. So I'm going to show you how it is rendered actually. So just a glance, so I'm going to show you a small demo now. So this site has been already built. It doesn't have much actually, so it just have a, you know, apart from your basic starter kit code, and as I shown, these are the three items that has been added, and I just written a mdx.mdx file. So this, hi. So I didn't apply much styles, I kept it very basic, but we can actually extend styles. So if you take a look at this, on your left side, there is a, you know, code block, and on your right side, the content of that particular code block. So as a user actually, you know, scrolls, this changes. So this is the actual, you know, good experience as a, you know, the person who is reading this post, right? So they will know, instead of, you know, going back and forth to understand the code, it is very easier for me, okay, at this point of time, what is the code which I should be, you know, reading it. What are the other things which I don't want to read it, you can hide it. So that's the code base gives you. Right? So let's see how it has been built. So if you look at here, within your code base component, again you are going to, all your children's are just a markdown content. So like say for an example here, I just put a small code snippet and then I write my explanation for that particular code snippet here, just a dummy content here. So say for example, this particular content is for this code snippet. So that means I'm explaining this code snippet with my content. And then I'll say highlight, the same snippet, but I'm adding further more few lines. And I'm saying like highlight the line number from 3 to 7. So that is what you see here. So when I'm scrolling here, on my heading 2, so these lines are highlighted. So this pretty animation is coming, and actually, you know, the other lines are blurred, and only what is interested you are going to show that. So that's pretty much. So another one is like you can add any number of code waves. Say for an example, there is no connection between this code snippet and the next code snippet, you can actually put it as a separate code wave component. So that will actually render it as a separate, you know, component in the same page. Yeah, that's pretty much. Thank you.